It's bitterly cold, the pitch is rock hard, but the ground is full of the warmth of passion which cup football generates. And for Clive Walker, there's the added ingredient of playing against his old team. He's been troubled by an ankle injury, but was fast fit this morning and takes his place in this Sunderland lineup. Gordon Chisholm and Dave Hodgson are also fit, but it's a team which lacks the presence of Mark Proctor and Howard Gale, both of whom are injured. Chelsea's team is as expected, with John Bumstead taking the place of the suspended Dave Speedy. So Kerry Dixon will plough a lone furrow down the middle. And the last time that Bumstead started a match was at Walsall back at the end of October, when Chelsea were just seconds away from going out of the Milk Cup in round two. Here's the Sunderland hero of the competition, Chris Turner, who's played brilliantly all through and had that vital penalty save against Tottenham Hotspur. But he's hoping tonight that the pressure will be on the man at the other end, the Chelsea goalkeeper, Eddie Nijbeski. The referee for the first leg of this semi-final is Don Shaw from Sandbach in Cheshire. Surprisingly, this is the first time these two sides have ever met in cup football. And Sunderland are attacking the goal to our right. They're in the red and white stripes, Chelsea playing in an all-yellow strip with a thin hoop. And the first free kick of the night goes to the home side. Clive Walker moving well forward. Four forward indeed for Sunderland. Hodgson number seven. On by Walker, but only to Thomas. Peter Daniel. Out by Colin Pates. Paul Cannavale to Thomas, two of the scorers in that remarkable 4-4 match. And Thomas indeed bringing Chelsea through to this round by getting the eventual winner against Sheffield Wednesday. And that's a very good cross, which is just too high for Kerry Dixon. Another couple of inches and that would have been an early gift for the London team. Cannavale, who started the move, Thomas supplying the cross, and Dixon, jumping from a rather standing position, couldn't make contact. Jerry Jones and Dave Hodgson. It's kept in. And Pates did well. Jones not quite so well. Bennett. Nigel Spackman. Clary put it out, and Chelsea just getting rid of the ball when any danger is threatened. The play will be held up. There's an injured player forward. Chelsea substitute, Dale Jasper. The injured player is McLaughlin. Chelsea coach, John Hollins, looking a little concerned. So away goes the unlucky Scott. Chelsea, not surprisingly, deciding that they have to make an immediate substitution. On comes Dale Jasper. The play will restart with the throw-in. Looks as though Spackman's gone into the back four, he's there at the moment, and Bumstead thumps it away. Pat Nevin, Cannavale, and the goalkeeper doing supremely well. Free kick against Mickey Thomas for over-exuberance. Chris Turner timing his movement out of goal. He had to come for the ball, although it was outside the area. And the header was perfection indeed. The Chelsea bench will know that McLaughlin has a fractured arm and has been taken to hospital. Bumstead got away with a handball, and I think Venison. Elliott gives himself the angle for the clearance. Steve Berry, chase for Dave Hodgson. Walker coming across the box. Got a man over who's Daniel Field for handball, and penalty has been given. Penalty for handball against the substitute, Dale Jasper. Hodgson had got free on the right. Walker made a run across. Daniel was unmarked now on the far side, and clearly handball by Jasper. So like the rest, he can only now stand and stare. It's up to Nijbeski against Colin West. Well, he went the right way. If anything, he went a little bit too soon, because the ball was above his dive. And the youngster makes the error which puts his team behind. West scoring for the penalty spot. Rather straighter than the goalkeeper had anticipated. It's the most frustrating sort of penalty if you're a goalkeeper, knowing that perhaps if you'd stood your ground, you might have made a save. But it's 1-0 to Sunderland. Chelsea's story of penalties continues, but in a rather different way this time. Canneville. Nevin. West. Is really the moment for Sunderland. They have the initiative. When you get one, you have to get two, is the theory. West, Berry and Bennett in each other's way. West, Walker. Oh, I say, what a screamer. And Chelsea have another injured player, but Berry and Bennett certainly in each other's way then. The ball hooked away by Bumstead. West completely missed his kick. Walker certainly did not. If it had hit the crossbar, it would have put the wood under serious threat. Here, Flords and Chelsea have another problem. And the injured party is Mickey Thomas. And the check of the heartbeat, it would seem, Mickey Thomas recovers. Nijbeski once more up into the night sky. Walker. Well, that's curling a lot, and Pates lost it for a moment. That was just a slip. Although Hodgson tried to suggest it was more than that. Dixon to chase. And Chisholm gets the ball up on the roof, but doesn't quite succeed in getting it over. Being lent on a bit by Dixon as he played it. I think he would agree with the observation. Jasper. Dixon underneath it. Calmly done by Venison. Confidence in an excellent goalkeeper. Hodgson and Jones. Hidden on by Spackman, clear handball by Hodgson right in front of the referee. Forearm that took the ball. Dixon is on the far side from the kicker's viewpoint. On the near is Nevin. Did well, finds Spackman. This is the chance, Thomas. There was a little moment of hesitancy there. It's a good play by Pat Nevin. Thomas is struggling a little bit, he's holding his arm awkwardly. This is Spackman. Now Cannavale and Thomas a little bit unsure who was going to take it there, and it cost them quite a lot. There was no chance for the man on the far post, who was Dixon. I think it might be argued that these teams enjoy a greater intensity of support than perhaps any other two teams in the land. And there's also a little side issue between two of the great athletes of the day. Steve Cram, a supporter of Sunderland, watching here at Roker Park, and back in London watching on his television, Sebastian Coe. Walker put in by Hodgson, good save. It was a lovely flick on, and it was a very even contest. Header first by West, Hodgson's flick, and Walker and Nizveski, it was absolutely evens. Plumstead. Daniel. Dixon. Marcus Backman. Cannavale. Lee. Pickering on the counter. Hodgson in receipt. West now behind him. Unmarked. 3 men in the middle. West, crowd anxious for the ball to be crossed, and Nizveski follows it all the way. Pickering, Bumstead. Again, nice control by Bumstead. Second occasion when he could so easily have overhit the ball. Cannavale. Daniel. Couldn't turn, and Spackman still managed to get part of his body in the way. Hodgson. An awkward one for Jasper, and Colin West, and Jasper escapes. West hopes for a moment that he might hear the whistle from a prostrate position. There was never any reason why he should, but it was a nasty moment for the young man again. Chelsea in all sorts of problems because Colin Lee's playing in the front line with his right thigh strapped up. So they've lost one man and had to move another. Taken off him by Spackman. There's no way that Lee can stretch for something like that. It's got to be played to his feet. Bumstead. And the referee finally blows the half-time whistle, and it was the Sunderland bench who were drawing his attention at the time, but they lead by one goal, scored by Colin West from the penalty spot after the handball by Dale Jasper. Chelsea losing John McLaughlin and carrying Colin Lee up front. Sunderland surely will never have a better chance of making sure that they get to Wembley. But if it would seem that the wind is blowing Sunderland's way, we will certainly need another goal in the second half to take with them back to Stamford Bridge in a week's time, if one is to judge by the performance that Chelsea put up in the first 45 minutes in spite of all their problems. Dixon, Nevin, foul by Daniel. It's curious how players either turn to the referee to complain or turn to the referee to say, yes, I realise you were right. It rarely produces no reaction at all, the referee's whistle. It's out by Bennett. Blackman provides the first shot of sorts in the second half. Hodgson, West, Hodgson. Captain gets his team out of trouble and the free kick. And once more the culprit is quick to acknowledge the error. Two sides nine places apart in the first division, Chelsea in ninth place and Sunderland in 18th, having had a run of five consecutive defeats in the league, which has put them in trouble. They ended the sequence by beating Stoke in their last home game here. Jerry Jones determined to get there first. Dixon. Nevin faced by Bennett. Dixon! Oh, that would have been one of the goals of the season! Lovely play by Chelsea. Pat Nevin playing the ball through on the line of the near post, and Dixon had made the run. Hit it without a second thought. Sunderland ball. Walker. Oh. Fine try, fully intended. Dipped down and had to be watched with great care. top scorer for Sunderland, Clive Walker. 10 goals for them this season. His tally when he was with Chelsea was 69 and a little short of 200 games. Thomas, Cannavale, Lee, acclaimed. Sometimes little men can cause more problems in the box than big men. Daniel. Steve Berry. Decides to leave it. Barry Venison. David Hodgson. Walker fails to turn Bumstead. Cannavale. Been very effective, Cannavale, coming from a deep left-sided position. A point header by Lee. And still the balance of play suggests the equaliser rather than the second goal for Sunderland. Nevin. And still, away by Bennett. Hodgson. Not really sure what he was going to do. This is Cannavale. Great run. Nobody on the end of it. Pulled it back to the right place, but nobody was coming onto it. They'd all been sucked in. Nevin. This is great stuff from Chelsea. Many a team would say, well, a 1-0 defeat away from home in a two-leg match would be good enough. Chelsea, it seems, never for one moment have thought about settling for that. Looked all the time for the equaliser. It's kind of losing their centre-half and having two other players with knocks. Elliott. Elliott again, and he was the back man then. Lee and Elliott exchange a few words and a little gentle push. Free kick against Hodgson. Zoe Jones, who saw so much cup football in Europe with Liverpool. Daniel. Dixon, Bumstead, Thomas, West, Thomas, Dixon, Sean Elliott, part of the Sunderland scene for so long. This is his biggest night. It's only 1 point away from a second suspension, incidentally. So if Sunderland get there, he might be in trouble. It's Backman, Nevin, Pickering. But lucky how that fell, and Nevin so quick. You'd think that Chelsea were the home team, but the Sunderland are reduced to the breakaways. Walker. Hodgson pulls away on the far side. Three waiting, only marked by two. Venison adds to the number. West gets in behind. Dixon. Elliott. Hodgson. Berry. Westy was pulled by Jasper. Not a penalty. No question. And the nightmare occurs for Dale Jasper. West, who got away from the throw-in, right on the edge, and the referee said, just in. And the man who was fouled has the chance of his second penalty. Would be his fourth of the season, and could be so important. Oh, and he got a foot, a hand to it, and West following up. Nijbeski pushed it onto the post, and then couldn't get to his feet in time. Colin West and the whole of Roker Park hugely relieved. But what words of consolation can be said to Dale Jasper? Nijbeski got a hand, pushed it onto the post, but just couldn't recover in time. Listen to the roar now. From behind the kicker. Nijbeski read it so well, but the post was not on his side, and the fates are not on Chelsea's. Lee. Nevin, Cannavale, put inside Pickering, and then got another bite. Speckman, good running forward by Joey Jones. Needs help. And Jones has got it back, but not for long. Jones with the free kick. 5 minutes left. Nevin for Chelsea. Three waiting. Cannavale. Corner. Jasper coming forward, hoping that things may turn his way. Jones climbed. West did a good job. Followed Dixon out. Cannavale desperate to lose Daniel if he can. Pates. Speckman. Whistle for the challenge. High bouncing ball has been a problem all the evening, indicative of how hard the pitch is. Slight miscue, but it fell safely enough. Nevin twists and turns. Goal kick. West, Hodgson, Bumstead, Jasper. Lee got the better of Elliott. Bennett, beautifully played. It appeals from Chelsea supporters, but not from Chelsea players. There's a moment then when the ball was around his midriff, and I think the Chelsea supporters felt that he handled it. In fact, he controlled it superbly. Blackman, Dixon, Thomas, away by Berry. Some of the crowd would like the final whistle. Frank Burrows, the number two here, waving his team forward. Terrible tendency to get forced back in the closing stages. The referee looks at his watch. And Ashurst presumably is counting the seconds from his position in the director's box. Here's under the manager. And the victory greeted as though it's decisive. Two goals from Colin West. Both of them from the penalty spot. But Eddie Zyzewski, both penalties conceded by Dale Jasper. What a sad evening for him. John Neal inquiring about the state of Mickey Thomas, who carried a knock all the way through, as did Colin Lee, after John McLaughlin had been carried off with a broken arm and replaced by a man, Dale Jasper, for whom the night turned so sour. But I am sure, as the two goalkeepers applaud their respective supporters, I'm sure that the Sunderland management feel that it is not over yet by any means. There is no question that the Chelsea management will feel exactly the same.